myself. Sure hurt. I was only able to get so much done last time. I just went ahead and filled that eye in because my camera was running low. I didn't realize I had been using my recording camera all day. So now I have it charged up. I have deleted some unneeded film. And this is still shaking. So my whole desk is moving. So now I'm ready to do some more of this project so I can show you what it would look like if you had your, have it fully swatched. I guess I decided to put shinies in the eye. Their eyes are so small. I might not use it because the smallest one to have. I think PC-1M. I believe this is like super fine. I'm not sure. This is my first Posca use of my first Posca marker, and I got it so I could do highlights and eyes or highlight around characters when I do my little projects. Make sure it's still functioning. It might be small enough. Let's see if I can do it. Not bad. Close enough. Anyway, it's small enough to manage it, so it's all primed and ready to go now. Use this for the eyes. Do these two today. If I can manage to shorten this film and not do too much chatting, I'll probably get them all done. Let's enter the Posca markers. I have them swatched, so I know which ones I used yesterday. Let's see if I put up the E15 and the E93. I will be using the Ohuhu liner pens for the other colors other than hair and skin. Some outfits I will still be able to use the skin tone markers. See if I can't mix up the colors a little bit. On that note, let me make sure I got the other one out that I used for pink yesterday. Oh, I do have that one. I used this one. Okay. Hair color. I might have to use a Ohuhu marker for some hair color. I don't know. I don't remember using it with the shuttle art markers. I have to go back and look at that film. It seems like I used a yellow one, but that might have been the marker. Called brown yellow or something like that. Alright, so these two might get used as hair color today on this one. This one is the one from yesterday, E11. Now, back to this E15. I think I have the shadows done on this. So, I'm going to be doing the eyes, the mouth, and the hair, and that. I didn't really have a yellow. I think the most yellow marker was the one I used for this skin color. So, I'll probably, even if I wanted to make it a yellow watermelon, the golden watermelon, I'd have to use a marker. Watermelon. It's close enough to the color. I might color on it with the marker I'm going to get the E0 out. And then try to blend it. The Ohuhu's not really made to smear, but it's a light color. It might smear for me. I might actually want it to smear this time. Okay, so I have the E11. It's going to go over here. E15. Alright. The mouth. Where is that marker? I put it up. Pink for the tongue. And the lips. Pretty good. Don't put too much extra lip on it. I do have kind of quite a bit of extra lip on this one. Should just leave it as a line and then just trace it out with the pen. But I want her to have lip. It bled a little bit. Forgot this is copy paper. Tiny a little bit more noticeable. Alright. Eyes. Have this one be green this time. Reminds me, I gotta put some of the eye back on it. Got brown blood into it a little bit. I'll fix that. A little bit of napkin. For that spot. Well, actually, I'm going to leave it. It'll dry out here while I'm focusing on the hair. Alright, let's do the watermelon because I want it to be golden. E00. I forgot this was brush nib. I'm so used to using the bullet nib. See if I can smear it. I forgot these are not acrylic markers. And the Ohuhu's not made to smear. I have to color that in fully. Golden watermelon. Last time I did one of this color, this image, the original one, did red watermelon. I learned in watermelon season here in the United States and the southern, southeastern, low southern states that there is watermelon called black diamond watermelon, orange crush. What was the other one? crush. Hope you guys will be able to know and to go back and listen. But if I was saying something important, I will not be removing that film. See, I'm going to need the black. What was that one called? Orange Crush, White Diamond. I don't remember the name of that one I ate. I should put two seeds and then three seeds. The yellow ones do have a lot of seeds. And I'm going to use a green one. There we go. Awesome. Let's see if it's dry enough for me to do that. There alrighty. This color for hair, the E93 for hair. Close to her face, really light hair. I will not color what the box is because that will be late for blending. We got this really long spot where I don't do a lot of talking because I wanted to leave areas where I could quickly color and speed up the video to save some time and cut down the video. The video before I began editing was 1 hour and 4 minutes, and a lot of it was mostly coloring. There wasn't a lot more to say because anything to be said about my experience with the new markers was said yesterday or today before. On the first time using the markers, but I do comment some more at the end of the video. I'm honestly enjoying coloring with these markers. The difference between a bullet nib or fine point and a brush is when you're the actual artist, there's such a difference. It's hard to explain it because it glides on smooth. It's not rough. It's just like if you're painting, but with a little bit more control. Even though it bleeds, it's still more controlled than if you were doing like acrylic marker, acrylic paint. And you may not be able to blend as well. I mean, you still blend, but not, well, I should say on this type of paper, you may not be able to blend as well as you can with acrylic paint. And acrylic paint will... They're covered up by the other painting. Since I didn't quite get it right. But that's all right. I'm still going to do some of this up here.
back to what I was saying, acrylic paint will ripple the paper but not bleed through. And you can mix both of them on palette with alcohol marker. You have to use alcohol. And so people have used rubber alcohol to make it like a watercolor. I mean, it's already see-through, but you can make it more like a watercolor, more faded looking. And with acrylic, you can add more water to make it more like watercolor and faded.
I'll just make it darkened. Should I cover that, some of that brown? Just make it a dark spot of the leaf. Dark spot on the leaf. Okay. Am I done? Ears. Okay. So I have that skin color swatched. I did just skin here, so I'm going to put the E00 over here. Oh yeah, not the 00. The 93. I did use the 00. So all right, the insects have come out, so I'm going to get quiet and let you listen to some insect sounds.
Got them marked. Oh, I need one more shiny spot in the eye. All right. Going to the... Oh, yeah. I just realized, well, actually... It's still good to have this move there, because even though I'm doing all one marker, if I was doing multiple marker sets in different squares, I would still need that rating. Next time, I will have my black Posca marker ready. I only wanted to use it for the eyes. That little dot, I didn't want to really use it for any part of the characters. I wanted to use only the Ohuhu liner and the Copic marker, the Copic CL, or CL, CIO, yeah, CIO. I was trying to remember how they would pronounce it if it was Japanese. The I is an E, and then the A is A. And O says its name. O. Was it C? Or was it K? It would be Kyle, wouldn't it? You know what? I haven't listened to any Japanese talk about the markers. So I will put that on my list to do. So I can get the pronunciation correct. If I'm going to talk about something, I want to be able to know the correct pronunciation. I'm learning how to use them, but at least the least I could do is pronounce it correctly. I know Copic is pronounced correctly. I have heard that said in the original language. And it starts with a C. So, would it be Copic Kyle? The first one starts with a C, Copic, and the second word starts with a C. I don't think they use a C with the S sound. I think Spanish does. Okay. I put 5 on this because I got no bleachies. But it just happened to be I'm getting better at using it. I forgot to got to trace in some lines.
forgot I put the paint on it before I traced over it. So it's kind of lumpy. And it's trying to clog up the marker. I'm in the pen. Thicker, like eyelashes. I won't always thicken up the eyelashes like this because it's usually something you see on teenagers and not little kids. Like, it looks like eyeliner or eyelash. What do you call it? Eyelash liner, I think it's called. I think it's called eyelash. Lash lengtheners. I don't use that type of makeup, so I don't even pay attention to the name of it. It's kind of funny. I made that pupil a little too big. The color of her eye. I'll make hers a lighter yellow. Or mix light and dark. You know, like when people have those hazel eyes. But then I would like it. Sometimes I have brown in it. Or it could be like blue, green. Closer to the eyes, the hair. Put the lighter green down here where there's not really any shadow. And then use the Copic marker to put the white in the corner of the eyes. Messed up. I could just color over the mistake with some green. Put the proper color in the proper spot. Now, color of the hair. I think I'm going to do two types of brown. Or this color. 11. With the E15. To put the darker color, and put the darker color closer to the face since the face is a lighter color this time. I need to go back over these with the black liner to trace out their face, but I kind of want to get the coloring done before I have too much of the camera used up. So I'm going to go ahead with the coloring, and then I will go back and line it, and when I get the lining done, I'll take a picture of it and put it at the end of my video, which is usually what I do when I finish a project. You see the finished part at the end. I'm just going to get quiet so I can speed this part up. You see me add my favorite dual or call it two-tone hair colors and making it so that I get the color down first, and then I'm gonna do
the black liner. But even without the liner, it looks pretty good. Well, I did the black liner on the eyes only and around the mouth. So I hadn't did it on the rest of the square yet. Or the other drawing. And it still looks pretty good. Yeah, it's just times that you don't have to use the liner. But in this case, I already used it on the first picture. So I'm going to continue to use it throughout all the pictures to make it a uniform. Make it come together. Here I'm doing the food. Originally I put chocolate smear on around the mouth on this one. She's doing the chocolate on the donut, which I mixed two colors there to make that light brown, like the glazed donut. And let's see, it looks like I mixed the 15 and the E15 and the E00 to make the light color part of the donut. And then I'm using the E00 to make the light color part of the hair. The brown on that color face really sets it off pretty good. And then after I do the lining, which, you know, I gotta do all the color and stuff, I enjoyed making the leaves with the color of the liner supposed to, the dark green and the light green, so it doesn't just look like a flat 2D drawing. It gets some depth to it. When I put the lining around it, I noticed it kind of made it stand out a little bit more so that it didn't look flat. So I guess if it's a sticker, it really don't matter because the sticker is going to have its own edges. But when it's a flat picture, you want to put the lines in the right places or the shadows and stuff so it doesn't look like it's a flat drawing. And as I fill in the color, you see it starts to look like it's not just 2D. It looks like it's starting to take on some dimensions. It's my favorite part of drawing. I was quiet for, it looks like, almost 15 minutes. Almost 15 minutes of this video. So it allowed me a lot of time off the time period for how long it was recorded. And took it down from 1 hour and 4 minutes to 49 minutes. Which I'm quite happy. Let me know if having my videos at 40 is too long, because what I can do is just do, like, right now I'm doing swatching, so it's longer, which I notice a lot of swatching videos are anywhere from 45 to an hour, because they're trying to swatch a whole set. These I did not pre-do, I didn't, you know, pre-line and all that stuff. If I had, it would have cut it a little bit, down a little bit, and then when I edit it, it probably been closer to 30 minutes instead of 40 or 50 minutes. So, I'm going to get those lines darkened. The next time I get on here or you see the video, it should be Saturday for me. Probably in the late evening, like this was coming out in my late evening. It's after 9, but before 10 o'clock. And you'll be able to see how the lines make it look, and how much faster or less, how much less time the video takes to be recorded. I made sure to kind of make the hair a little different from the two. Even though they both have a light color, one's a lighter swatch. And even though they use the same brown as the basic darker color in the hair, the second color is different. That way, they're not exactly the same hair color, so it looks different, a different hairstyle and different hair colors. I wish I had remembered to put the nice, tasty donut chocolate around the mouth, and the other one had the little watermelon smear on the corner of the mouth like the original drawing, but they look like they've been enjoying themselves, so that's great.
Definitely unify it with the rest of the art. All the drawings are going to be outlined in black. So I need to do the same thing for this one and the other one. gonna have them all done beforehand this time. So all I have to do is color them. Sometimes I like my stickers and stuff without the liner. But when you're doing coloring, like if you're making coloring pages, or like these, if we're going to make copies of them, there needs the line art is important. I do like tracing after I've done it, because then you're just chasing around the color. That is fun sometimes. But for what I use these swatching sheets for, in order to make copies on the long run, all my swatching sheets need to have the dark liner on it. You can make lines that weren't there when you color it first and then do the liner. That I like. It's like almost like magic. You see the color and then you put shape over the color instead of putting the shape and coloring the shape. So this will conclude, once I finish tracing these, this will conclude my video for today. The next one won't be until Saturday, which I know is a good gap, but I have other videos that I made that I need to get out to see what's going on Fallout, and to show you what it looks like when the responders have to deal with the Scourge. That's all I'm going to say about that. When I got through filming it, it was kind of fun looking.